Hello everyone. So I'm here to do a Friday Reads, but as I'm filming this, it's still Thursday. And that is because tomorrow I'm getting married. So even if it's going to be a small thing, my family is not able to come and my partner's family is also not able to come. So it's just going to be, I think, a grand total of 6 people there. But still, I don't think I will have a lot of time to film anything or read much until tomorrow. So I thought I'll do the Friday reads on Thursday instead. And the other interesting thing is that I am going to be on holidays next week, partly because of the wedding and partly because it's also my birthday next week. So we decided to have a trip. We're renting a car and driving around Germany. I think we are going to reach all the way to Berlin. So that's very exciting. I haven't had a holiday since last year, so I'm really happy about that. So yeah, that means that I will not be filming this on Friday, and I will also not have a Friday reads next week. I have pre-recorded some things, so in case you were going to miss me so much, you'll still have some content from me, but it's not going to be a Friday reads or anything like that. So yeah, that is the status of what's going on in my life right now. It's a bit stressing, but I'm happy that it's almost done, so I can relax. Yeah. So, more exciting things, by the way. Kieran, who is Katie Books, he's lovely. I'll put a link to his channel below. I told him that I wanted to read the Tsetse Dangarembas trilogy, but I was not finding a copy of the Book of Knots. So I was planning to read the first and the third one, but he was like, no, wait, I'll send you the second one so that you can read it as well. And it arrived. This is so nice, Kieran, thank you so much. Also, because I know that you hate this cover, I thought I would make a small dust jacket for this book, just for you, so that we can get rid of that cover. Yeah, I hope you appreciate that one. And if you want your copy back, let me know and I'll send it back with the dust jacket. So, jokes aside, we also had the announcement of the Booker shortlist this week. I was not completely happy about that. You can see my reaction video. I'll link it down below as well. It's just a prize. It's fine. We'll survive it. So yeah, that's all housekeeping that we had to do, I think. So I think it's time to talk to you about the things I have read this week. I haven't read so much because I had a ton of things to do, but I have read some stuff still. So the first thing that I finished that I was reading last week is Catch and Kill by Ronan Farrow. And this one is a non-fiction book about the Harvey Weinstein scandal, and Ronan Farrow was one of the journalists that helped discover that, or like bring it to light. Most people in the industry kind of knew what was happening, but he actually got hard proof and brought it to light so that he could be convicted. And I in this book he tells us about his experience with the investigation and that whole process, and how he found the women to talk to, and what was that experience as well. I quite enjoyed those parts, the parts in which he tells the experience about how the whole process was. I did not care so much for the actual gossipy parts about what the people in Hollywood were doing and saying, because I barely know who Harvey Weinstein is. I don't think I knew his name until he was convicted, and I saw his name in like night shows like Trevor Noah and stuff like that. And I don't know many of the other names that come up on the book, so that part was a bit. I didn't feel that part so much, but the part in which he explains the whole process of how journalists investigate for their pieces, and also even the stories by the women that were molested by Harvey Weinstein, were quite interesting to read. So, yeah, that was my opinion on that one. The next one I finished was Shuggie Bain by Douglas Stewart. I think I was also reading that last week already. That was one of the books in the Booker longlist and now in the Booker shortlist. And I liked it. I don't think I loved it as much as everybody else. I just think it's a story that has been told before, so I was a bit disappointed. If you are interested in more thoughts about that one, I'll have that review up next week, so you can go watch that. And then the last one I finished is A Single Thread by Tracy Chevalier, and this is part of my BookTube Prize judging. It's in the final of the fiction category. So I cannot talk about it until the winner is announced, I think in October, beginning of October. So I'll talk about that one then. So sorry, I cannot talk about many of the books I read, but yeah, at least you know what I read. The books I'm in process of right now, I'm currently listening to The Book of M by Penn Shepherd. This is a dystopian book in which it's sort of a pandemic in which people start losing their shadows, and when someone loses their shadows, then they start also forgetting things about their life, until they kind of forget they need to eat and drink and die. And so in that dystopian apocalyptic world, there's a group of people that have shadows and a group that don't have shadows, and they fight with each other, and they're trying to find a way to survive, basically. It has connections as well to Indian mythology, which I'm finding very interesting. But overall, I have 4 hours left of the audiobook, which is, I think, 16 hours. And I'm finding it a bit long. But yeah, it's still an enjoyable read to listen to when I'm running or cleaning or whatever I'm doing. It's a good book to multitask with. So yeah, I'm enjoying that. And the other one, I'm 50 pages away from the end, I think. It's How Much of These Hills Is Cold by Sipam Sang. And this one is also part of the Booker longlist, not the Booker shortlist anymore. Which was quite of a shock. And this one is a very poetic, lyrical book about a girl called Lucy, who is from Asian descent. And she lives in America, in the mining towns. I think in the 1800s, maybe? It doesn't specify. And it's about her struggles. And her relationships with each member of her family. I am also going to review that one once I finish it, so I'll put a link to that review whenever it's up. But yeah, that one, I am liking it, but there are also issues with it that that I can see, of course. But I'm liking it so far. I have to say it does feel like a debut in some ways. But yeah, it is an enjoyable read, and I can see why people like it so much. And why people are so disappointed that it was not in the shortlist. But yeah, those ones are the two that I'm reading. I'm hoping to finish those like very, very soon, maybe today. And then I have a stack of books that I kind of sort of really want to read in September. I don't know if I will be able to, but since I am not going to do a Friday read next week, I thought I would just share all of them. So the first one I have to read is 10 minutes 38 seconds in this strange world by Elif Shafak, and this is the last one from the Book to Prize that I have to read. And as I understand, this one is about a prostitute that dies, and this 10 minutes 38 seconds that refers to how much your brain still working once your heart stops, and sort of like the last minutes of these prostitutes and things that she thinks about, I think. So yeah, I'm very excited about this one. I have not read Elif Shafak before, and I'm really excited to try her. So this one I'm excited for. The next one I have is Redhead by the Side of the Road by Anne Taylor. This one was in the long list of the Booker Prize as well. And I have heard it's just a fun, fast read. I don't expect much from this, but since I'm on holidays next week and it's actually the Booker Boy Book Club pick for next week, I'll read it as well. It's very short, so I should be able to read this next week. Then of course I want to read the Book of Not, and I have this Mournable Body in ebook, so once I finish this I can dive into that, and I'm hoping to do that soon as well. Then I have 1984 by George Orwell, which is part of my reread project. I want to reread a book every month. I haven't read this since, I don't know if it was teenage years or early 20s, but a long time ago, and I'm really excited about diving into this again. And I want to also review it, but we will see how that goes. And then one that I mentioned last week but I was not able to go into was Everything Under by Daisy Johnson, and again this is, I think, about nature and womanhood, and I don't know much more about it, but I want to try it out because I it was all over BookTube a couple of years ago, so I think that will be interesting. And the last one I found that I was very excited to find is Temporada de Huracanes by Fernanda Melchor. This is hurricane season. This was in the shortlist for the International Booker, and it's supposed to be very brutal but sort of whimsy at the same time. It's about the death of a witch in a small town in Mexico. And yeah, I am excited about this. I don't always get along with Mexican literature because it's quite brutal at times. Like, I read a few years ago 2666 by Bolaño, and that one was, at some point it was just a list of how many prostitutes had been murdered in a certain town and how they have been dismembered exactly. So I hope this is not like that, but yeah, we will see. And it's in Spanish, so I should be able to get a good way into that one soon. And then the last one I want to read in September is Solitary by Albert Woodfox, which I have in ebook as well. And that one is the last one I have to read for the non-fiction BookTube prize finalist. I'm not judging that, but I still want to read them all, so I have a sense of what I want to win. So that one is the last one I have to read, and I'm hoping to do that before the winner is announced. So yeah, I know there's a lot of books, but we'll see. I don't know how much I will be able to read next week in holidays. It might be all the time because I don't have to work, or it might be not at all because we are visiting places and doing things all the time. So we will see. I'll let you know when I come back. So yeah, see you in the next video, and until then, bye.